Hi everybody, I'd like to welcome back to my channel. Hope everybody is doing great on this Saturday afternoon. I'm putting my titanium white base Amsterdam on, popping my bubbles. My rated shells for my top base will be listed in the description below. You will find them below my video. All my paints and my base has the same recipe and the same ratios. I use Floetrol, distilled water, and the paint. My ratios are, like I said, listed below in the description box. This is a Dutch pour that I'm doing today. And I have, well, first I'm going to go ahead and go with my turquoise, my SoHo turquoise. I'm having a difficult decision here to make my design. I decided to go with a little bit of negative space, or tried to anyway. So I start off with my turquoise, my darker color. All of the SoHo is new paints for me that I'm trying out on this 10x10 canvas wrap. This is Alizon Crimson Red that I'm adding on the top of it. And then I have the SoHo Bronze as well. I'm placing that on to make sure that I get just a little bit in there for a little bit of shadow. Get that little drip off of there. Couple of them. Not hard to get out in the beginning, but you want to make sure you get your drips, get everything out of the way, and get all your drips if you need to cover all their sides as they drip off. Now here I start noticing that I don't like that there is a big old blob or a spot, so I'm going to blow with my mouth to separate the spots that are too close together. That's why I put the extra base here on in just a few minutes, so that I have enough to do that with. Sorry about my big head in the way. Now here I find that the shapes, some of the parts are because of the parts, I don't like it. So I use my finger on this side. You'll notice that I use my finger to start shaping it up a little bit. Now, of course, I've got a torch before I make that decision, but once I do, I will put it on there, I will shape it with my finger, and then I'll need to put more of my base coat on there, because I realize that I can't get it to do anything, because it's just not enough. I need more negative space. always take a step back and look at it before you decide to make a decision whether or not you want to scrape or you want to shape. I'm scraping and getting used to the new mat as well. I got a new silicone mat from Lolavive. I believe that's the name of it, Lolavive. It's off of, I'll also put that in my description box below. But here you can tell I'm starting to do my finger painting and my shaping with my leftover drippings from the bottom that has fallen off the sides. You want to do all this while you can, you've got the wet paint that's dripped off. I hope everybody's having a great day. So far, mine's been pretty good. I'm going to have another painting. As soon as this one is done, I'm going to be doing a 10x10. And it's going to be a soft with the softer color of yellow and gold. And there's my big head in the way again. Apologize for that. Finger painting the rest. Here's the finger paint. I do not like that. Do not like that at all. So, giving it some more negative space. It's always sometimes to do that better with your finger than it is to do with the spatula. Once I finish fiddling with all this, it actually turns out to be a pretty good painting. I thought I had totally messed it up, but I did not. And you will see in the end that it's not too bad. I actually liked it. This is my outlet, you guys, for a lot of my stress. Keeps me from thinking about my pain. And I know you all know I'm a little bipolar, so my mind is always switching and thinking, so I use that to my advantage. Scraping once again. Never can do that too much from the bottom, because when you get ready to move it from one place to the next, if you have to do that, I do not like to move it once I get my studio. I will not be moving my paintings. I will be leaving them probably set where they are. Right now I'm having to use my kitchen while my studio is being remodeled. My last and final blow on this one side, kind of shape it out and make it a little bit softer. So far, coming together pretty good. I want to thank you guys for stopping by today on my channel. And please take the time. Don't take but a second. It doesn't cost anything. To subscribe. There's a lot of information in the description boxes below. And if you can, you can support me. I have a PayPal set up. You do not have to. I just don't get affiliates just to help me out until I get 500 subscribers. Here we go. This is the finished before it's dried. So, it really turned out to be pretty. A lot of copper in there. Got a lot of sales. But subscribe, hit that bell, notification bell, give me a thumbs up. And I guess I'll see you guys in the next painting. Well, I know I will. I hope so. Thank you. And you guys have a great day.
And a beautiful tomorrow.